couple buckets for yourself to get to the free throw line. Was there an impetus in kind of how Detroit was playing where you wanted to be a little more aggressive there, and how have you felt like you've grown into that role here?
No, I was just trying to play basketball. That's what I do every game, just trying to make the right play, just score, pass, whatever. Just happy with one.
Maybe sitting next to you here, I'll ask you about him. His last, not just this game, but the last game, the deliberate energy and efforts in the paint. What did you see there, and what's your responsibility as a guard when he's doing that?
Get him the ball. He rebounds everything on the other end. So on the offensive end, just give it to him. You know, he's been a monster this whole season, but definitely the last three games or so. But that's what he does. That's what he's capable of doing, and we all know it. Everybody knows it.
Hey, D, you know, we sat here after some tough finishes for you guys tonight. I think from 5-minute mark about, got points on 8 straight possessions. I think you scored on 6 of those. What did you feel was the difference in your closing offense than, you know, what you guys have done the last couple of games where you dropped games like this?
We're getting organized. You know, we're coming down the floor and getting into, you know, our sets, and not just coming down with random offense. So, you know, when we come down and get set and get the matchup that we want, and, you know, we usually get something good, you know, whether it's a layup or dunk or a good shot, offensive rebound, like whatever it is. For the last couple games, we've been very mindful of time score situations. And, you know, anytime we come down, you know, in crunch time, we want to make sure we get to, you know, one of our sets, one of our actions, and get a good look.
And also, you know, your first back-to-back of 30-plus points since, I think, February. Is that significant to you, or does that signify anything about the rhythm you're starting to feel?
No, exactly. We won. You know, other than it's 0 points and we won. And, you know, we all go, we got to get wins. So I don't, bless and stuff to take care of itself. So, you know, we can't get comfortable. We've been in this situation before, you know, lose 5, win 2, lose 5, win 2. So, got to put a string of wins together to get back in this thing, but we got to take one game at a time.
Okay. After the time off, you guys let up 37 in the first quarter, and what do you think got you going from that point on? Was there any, overthinking it in that moment, like, oh man, we can't let this slip away? But what do you think got going in the second beyond?
More intensity, more energy, more effort. You know, having 4 days off, just told back in the locker room, I've never had that in my career, you know, besides the All-Star. Like, we never, you know, especially early in the season, we get 4 days off. So, you know, getting back into the swing of things on the defensive end and on the offensive end, you know, we came out kind of slow. But, you know, second quarter, and it was our second unit. You know, our second unit came in, you know, time is winging. You know, especially those two DS came in and changed the momentum of the game, got us back in it on both ends of the floor. And, you know, we just kind of stayed with the energy and that momentum. But we picked up defensively in the second half, in the second quarter on, and also on the offensive end.
Thank you.
You played with Dennis before. Mm-hmm. So what's the benefit of having him back with you guys tonight and also Thomas?
Another ball hawk. You know, he's picking up full court. You know, he's making the right reads on the offensive end. You know, obviously going to take him time to get back. One, it's a game shape, two, and, you know, have a rhythm. But he played big for us tonight. You know, Thomas, like the Thomas we expect, you know. I think the biggest thing for both of them is just getting their win. But both these guys played huge for us. Got some big bucks and got us back in the game.
Do we have any questions for Austin?
No, we're good. We're good. Okay. Y'all keep talking to him.
No, I'm just here. Tell you can go.
No, I'm good.
Austin, there was a play where we're kind of running down the sideline chasing down a loose ball and got thrown into the front row. A bunch of drinks got spilled, I think. It seemed like the bench kind of enjoyed that. I'm curious kind of what they said to you when you walked back over there.
I asked Brown if that was his logos over there. It smelled horrible.
I'm an investor, bro. What you mean?
It don't mean it don't taste good. It's just having fun, you know. We do this for a living. You got to have fun with moments like that. And that's basically it.
And more seriously, these last two games have come with LeBron out. I know you want to make the right play and be unselfish and stuff like that, but once he comes back,
Can you, or should you kind of demand the ball this way and try to be this productive, even when this team's at full strength?
Yeah, nothing changes, you know, for me when you come back. You know, I mean, and we've seen it before when he's playing, you know, a couple years ago. So nothing's changed. I think we'll be fine, you know, and like I said, you know, just trying to get a chemistry. Obviously, he's coming back, and this time is coming back. So it is tough when our guys miss games, because then, you know, we don't have a lot of practice time. And, you know, these guys are, you know, hurt, so we want to be mindful of that when we practice, and so we get a lot of time in together. But, you know, we know what we can be. And when these guys get back, you know, find their rhythm, I think we'll be even better.
Last two.
Good fellow shirt, too, man.
I have a question. Give me a second.
Awesome. So you guys put six in double figures tonight, and you rested, and you won a couple games in a row, and LeBron will be returning at some point. Does it start to feel like fun and good, and like what's the belief level with this team right now?
Like I've said many times, you know, we're very new team to each other, so it's going to take a little bit of time to get used to playing with one another. But yeah, the belief's high. I mean, you've seen tonight the way we scored the ball. You said six and double figures. You know, there's a lot of people on the team that can win us basketball games. So at the end of the day, it's just going to come down to playing the right way and competing on the defensive end, because we have the capability of being a really good defense. If we do that, then offensive end will take care of itself.
Last question. I have a similar question to you, AD. I just wanted to know, how is the relationship between you guys has been? And do you feel like you're finding the identity between you guys?
Really?
Yes.
Yeah. Piggyback what Austin just said. We're starting to find our rhythm. You know, we've every loss we learn from, you know, and every win we learn from. You know, we don't want to get too high, don't get too low. And our guys are, you know, communicating better. We're being more mindful of our shot selections, more mindful of our defensive, you know, pressure intensity. You know, tonight our biggest thing was fouling, you know, but, you know, everything is self-inflicted, you know, when we make mistakes. So, but we're doing a good job of, you know, finally finding a groove, finding a rhythm, coming together. And, you know, like I said, the next step is just, you know, doing it for multiple games in a row where we can, you know, run off a couple of wins and start a win streak to get back in this thing.
Thank you so much.